Welcome to lesson 6. At this point, you guys can build just about anything. You can collect data from users, you can build pretty web pages, you can store all this stuff in databases, you can manipulate this database, you can build logins, all sorts of cool things. And when you think about it, just about every website on the internet is some combination of the things you've already learned how to do. So it's pretty cool that you've gotten this far. Now, one of the things we haven't touched on yet is how to build websites that operate at a larger scale. That is, that more than just a couple of people can use. When you start having websites operating at a big scale, lots of things can break down. You can run out of disk space for your data. You can run out of bandwidth to serve all of the amazing stuff that you have. Or you can run out of, you know, processor time to actually generate all of the amazing computations you're doing. Right? There's all sorts of different things that are limiting factors in how your website functions. And we're going to learn how to address each of those things, how to use multiple machines if you need to, and that sort of thing, so you can actually build a large-scale website. So let's jump right in.